Yeah. deck. Continuing perimeter sweep.
So you came, courier. To what? Watch your homeland burn one last time? Kill me, perhaps? Judging by your shadow, maybe you can't let your machine go. Doesn't matter now. Either way, the Divide Giants are awakening. The missiles here on their way home. There is no way to stop them. You've answered your own question, and you'll die with that question on your lips. You don't see, listen, even when it's all around you. No matter if I nailed it into your head like a gift from Kaisar. You brought the Divide to life, courier. You walked the road, brought the bear, then the bull, brought me. Following your tracks. And when I saw the divide you made, I saw a second chance, a new way of thinking. My world, no longer the East. And you brought the West in that package, destroyed it all, nearly killed me, flesh and spirit. You destroyed something larger than the bear, greater than the bull. And even when you could have turned away, you brought it again in that machine. You destroyed a nation taking its first breath. A place that could have been my home. Now, I'll destroy yours. No. Now there is purpose. I believe you when you say you were careless. The divide, the chip, the machine you brought here. Many messages can be taken from that, intended or not. What I do now is an act of conviction. Blame you? No. Learned from you. Both the weapon to kill a nation, and the strength to do it. You showed me a road, a way to carry my message. You've already answered for what you've done. Now the flag you follow will answer for it. No, not the Mojave. The West. All that's been built since America died. Same symbols as before the war. Now a flag carried by a tribe of children. You walked the West, didn't stay. You know the reason. The bear grows without structure, follows a symbol without knowing its history. After this, only one flag will remain over the Mojave. Let that one fly. Or destroy itself. No need to destroy the bear. Just cut its throat. You taught me that at the Divide. Only need to cut off the supply line, the road, to watch something greater die. I'll turn the Long 15 into miles of fire. Cut off the Mojave. NCR will fall back, lose Hoover Dam, and leave their throats exposed to the Legion. Yet you follow nothing at all. You have walked the Mojave. Let the shadow of flags fall upon you. Yet walk carelessly, no allegiance, your words empty as your actions. The why of it. You taught me the why of it. If you believe in something enough, you must be willing to let it burn, lest it claim you. These governments of the two-headed bear, the Legion, they carry old world ideas into an age that no longer needs them, where they cannot live. Comes down to perspective, how far one's walked, and what they've left behind. If you challenge this moment, let's hear your perspective. If my words are all you have, let's hear them. My tribe, that log, no, it concerned the White Legs, training them to kill. For Kaisar, there is no meaning there beyond the road to New Canaan, the history of the murder of its people, and Kaisar's past. New Canaan, my tribe. If you've heard my words, and that's all you've taken from them, then I was right to cast them aside. If you ever had any ability to hear anything beyond your own footsteps, the Divide silenced it. Now, its voice will end you. I'll finish history's work. If the Divide couldn't kill you, perhaps these spears of the old world can. Let's end this, Courier. You and I, here, with the old world flag as witness. God.
Experiment log 369248/A. I bought Duraframe Universal Interface Override System. This is Dr. Whitley presiding. Initial tests of the override system are promising. Against unsecured or lightly encrypted targets, the iBots have a 98% success rate. More heavily protected systems are still problematic. Military-grade encryption presents a very real possibility of critical overload of key systems. We've stopped tests before any robots were destroyed. But if we don't address the problem, our iBots will fry themselves hacking military networks.
At the end of the struggle, only one courier remained in the heart of the divide. The true courier. Courier 6. The courier tore the ancient flag of the Commonwealth from its cables and cast it over the corpse. Though whether done as a sign of respect or in anger for what had been endured to reach this moment, that is unknown. Interpretation is something best left to history, and only the surviving courier would ever know for certain. His back on his home for the second time and made his way back, navigating the treachery of the divide. Tunnelers and the marked men avoided the lone figure, as if recognizing the courier's right to passage, or out of fear. The courier walked until he stood again upon the edge of the divide. The last road he would walk before the second battle for Hoover Dam. There, beside his feet, was a final package from one courier to another. A footlocker bearing a gift and a message. But that message, it is something for couriers to carry, and for them alone. The lights flickered across the divide, reminders that the old world histories persist and find meaning in the present. It said, war, war never changes. Men do, through the roads they walk. And this road has reached its end.